blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name.
Blessed be your name on the road marked with suffering.
And it's painful.
You are holy,
you are holy,
and you are mighty, soon. Of the Lord in this house tonight. Woo! You need to take a deep breath in. It's the breath of God that you're breathing in this house. Hallelujah!
It's the word. It'll feed you daily if you read it.
This is my daily bread.
It's God's spoken word, written down on paper for you and me to read it. Oh, it'll speak to you. God's in the house tonight, church. Hallelujah. He's walking up and down these aisles. Are you desperate tonight? Do you have to have him in your life? Are you lost without him? I feel that way tonight. If I don't have Jesus, I'm lost. Oh, I got to have him in my life. I'm desperate. I'm desperate. I gotta read his word. This year in 2017, I gotta read his word. I gotta read his word. It's written down on paper for me to read. I gotta read it. I gotta put it in my brain. I gotta put it in my mind. Oh, I gotta read the word. I'm not gonna make it if I don't read his word. It's gonna be hidden in my heart. I gotta hide your word in my heart that I would not sin against you alone. I gotta learn how to walk in the spirit and not in the flesh. If I walk in the flesh, I won't fulfill the lust of the flesh. I gotta walk in the spirit. Oh, Go ahead, speak in tongues tonight, church. It's God's language. He wants you to talk to Him. He doesn't want you to speak English. He wants you to speak His language. You accomplish more in the spirit than you do in the flesh. Come on now, renew yourself in the Holy Ghost. Renew yourself in the Holy Ghost. I've got to have your spirit. I've got to have your spirit down on the inside of my soul, manifesting itself in my life. They got to know I'm saved this year. They got to know I'm a Christian. They got to know I'm Pentecostal. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. It is the power of God unto salvation. You won't have salvation if you don't have holiness. I'm not ashamed of the way I live. I am a peculiar person. I am a separated, chosen individual unto God. Control over my tongue. I said I have control over my tongue. Woo! Ramasaya dalamasikaya talamasayata. Oh, some of you need to get control tonight. Iya ramasandalamasiya dalamasayata. Get control of your thoughts. Bring every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. You young people need to get the Holy Ghost. Going to heaven without the Holy Ghost. You better get the Holy Ghost in 2017. You gotta make it. You gotta make it. We're taking you with us, children. We're taking you to heaven with us. Woo! Oh, I'm desperate. I'm desperate. I'm desperate. I'm desperate. This year is a year of victory. Look what the Lord has done. We had someone baptized in Jesus' name, January 1st at 12:15 a.m. What a way to start the year for Cross Creek Apostolic Church. We need one of those every single week. Every single week, someone baptized in His name and filled with His Spirit. You better bring your lost loved ones. You better bring your lost co-workers. We need to fill out this place with sinners. Sinners. They need to be saved. We're saved. We gotta have some sinners in the house.
Into Him. Hallelujah.
I'm lost without You.
Thank You, Jesus.
I'm lost without You.
I need You tonight, God. I'm lost without You tonight.
I'm lost without You.
Aromo hokoya rabahasata.
I'm lost.
You're here tonight and you need a special touch. I want you to walk down front right now. You have a special need. You want God to do something specific for you. Come on, don't drag it out. Come on down. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm going to have a Brother Isaac and Brother Michael. Hallelujah. To walk down and pray for you tonight. Brother Little, will you come and help us tonight? Hallelujah. Sister Angela, you can help us with some of the ladies. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sister Maria, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we touch you tonight, God. We bind every principality. We bind every power of darkness. We bind the rulers of wickedness tonight in high places. We take power in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we command faith to arise. We command the enemy to be scattered. We command the doors to be opened. We command the captive to be set free. And we command healings to come forth. Let faith arise in the name of Jesus. Bind every principality tonight, God. Loose the chains, I pray, O Lord. He koraba hatai. He soromo hatoi. He karama mahatai. He loromo hotoi, he saramamahai, he korobo hotoi. In the name of Jesus, loose your power, loose your anointing. Give them liberty tonight. For it's not by our might or our power, but it's in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, be loosed. In the name of Jesus, be set free. In the name of Jesus, be healed tonight. He borobo hotoi, he tarabahatai, hatsokoi, he karamahai, he loromo hosandarabahai. Loose your power tonight, God. Loose your anointing upon your people. Harabakayorobo hosatai, he lamamahatai, he korobo. Let the glory of the Lord shine down upon us tonight, oh God. Hallelujah. 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 Come on now. Praise him and thanking for his touch and thanking for his power. Thanking for deliverance tonight. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I receive my miracle. In the name of Jesus. I receive my miracle. You are faithful, God. Pour out your glory. Pour out your power. Pour out your anointing tonight, God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Harabaka robo hosatarabahai. Ito romo hotoi. Hatarabaka yandai. Hallelujah. Oh yes,
I'm lost without
you. We're lost without you tonight, God. Endue us with your power. Endue us with your power. Hallelujah.
I'm lost without you.
I'm lost without you tonight, God. I've got to have your time. We've got to have your deliverance power. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
I'm desperate for you.
Oh yes, Lord, have your will, have your way. Have your will, have your way, God.
Without you.
Hallelujah.
Come on, lift your hands and give him praise. Give him praise, thanking for his touch. Thank you for his power. Thank you for his glory. Thank you for his anointing. In the name of Jesus, we give you glory tonight, God. Thank you for our touch tonight. Oh, mighty God, we worship you. We praise you. We thank you tonight, God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Will you seek after him? Come on. Seek after him tonight. Lift your hands and seek after the presence of God. Seek after the power of God. Seek after his anointing. Seek after his anointing tonight. Seek after him with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul. I'm desperate for you, God. I'm desperate for you. In the name of Jesus, 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 in the name of Jesus. Aramoko yarama asata, iloroboko yata yashoromohoto, hiparamoko yandaraba, hashoromohoto yaka yataraba. Oh, have your way, Jesus. Have your way. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Here's what I want you to do. I want everybody to find somebody one-on-one to pray for. Praise God. All you guys can go down and pray for somebody. Praise God. You guys stay here. Find you a prayer partner. The Bible says that you have not because you ask not. Hallelujah. Praise God. Brother Fred, come on down and get with Michael and Brother Little over here. Praise God. He said you have not because you ask not. So I want you to share your number one desired prayer with each other tonight. And when I tell you to pray, I want you to pray specifically for those things. Hallelujah. Amen. Take a moment. Go ahead. Share with one another. Hallelujah. Whatever it is you have need of tonight. Hallelujah. Now, the Bible says when we pray, pray believing that we will receive them. Pray believing tonight that you will receive whatever it is you're asking for. Because faith calls those things that are not as though they are. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus tonight,
We pray for one another. We lift up our brothers and our sisters before you tonight, God. You know every need that is in this house, whether it be physical or financial or spiritual or relationship, God. We ask you to take power and dominion and authority. Hallelujah. Meet the individual need this morning, tonight, God. Those that need healing, I rebuke all sickness. I rebuke all pain in the name of Jesus Christ. We take power. We take dominion. We take authority through the blood of the Lamb in the name of Jesus. You said, by your stripes, we are healed. We claim that virtue. We claim your power. Those that need wisdom and knowledge and direction, Lord, close the doors you want closed. Open the doors you want open. Lead us in the paths of righteousness. Hallelujah. Let the chains be broken. Let the captive be set free tonight. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hakorabahatai. Hisabakoi. Hikorabahatai. Hatoriandoi. Hatsariandarabahai. Hikoromohotoyatai. In the name of Jesus. Not by our might or our power, but by your spirit tonight. Breathe that breath of refreshing down upon my brother or sister tonight. Let the joy of the Lord be their strength. Let faith arise. Let the enemy be scattered tonight. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Open every door. Make every pathway straight. Let thy will be done. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, let your angels have charge round about us, God. Hallelujah. 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 Now I want you to worship the Lord. I want you to thank him. I want you to break, hallelujah, shake off every chain, worship the Lord in the spirit of, hallelujah, in the power of his might. We praise you. We praise you. We exalt you. We bless you. We magnify your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hitarabahatai. Hallelujah. 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 Halabohosai. Hikorababahai. Hilorobohosandai. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Every shackle be broken. Halabokorobohotoi. Come on. Giving praise, worshiping, praising, blessing, magnify him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Harabakayo robo hosatai. Hito robo koya rabahatai. Hisharyandoi, Hattarabahai. Hallelujah. 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 All right. Praise God. Some of you haven't broken through yet, but I'm going to believe God before you, we end this service tonight, that you will break through. Amen. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God.
I'm going to get a couple preliminaries out of the way. I'm going to ask that everybody stay in the sanctuary tonight. Praise God. So, Sister Sweeney, I know you normally teach, or you or Sister Valerie, but the kids, I just feel like having everybody in the sanctuary tonight. Praise God. Hallelujah. Brother Little, if you'll receive our offering tonight, amen. And hallelujah. We're going to receive our offering, get the preliminaries out of the way, and then we're just going to go ahead and have church. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'd like to remind everybody, hallelujah, especially if you're a staff member, that on Saturday the 14th, that's a week from this Saturday, we will be having staff meeting, amen, and we're going to have it at my house instead of the church, so that is a correction, amen, so hallelujah, because I double booked and there is a district Bible quizzing event here at our church on that same morning, so amen. Our staff meeting will be at my house. Bible quiz will be here at the church that night. Saturday, January 14th, will be winter fire for all our hyphen and youth. Amen. I've been told that the youth is also invited. Praise God. And our district youth president, Brother James Barnes, will be preaching in that service, and it's right here at your home church. So please come out 7 o'clock p.m. 3 days of prayer and fasting, January 17 to 19. Purpose Institute starts in the month of February. Amen. Pick up a bulletin I don't have them out on the front desk. They'll be out there by Sunday. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Would you stand? Let's pray over the offering tonight. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray, God, bless the gift, the giver, those that have not tonight. Let your blessings be upon your people. Let everything be done to your glory. Let your anointing fill this house. I thank you for your presence that we feel even in this place, even now, God. We pray not our will, but thine be done. In Jesus' name, amen. As they sing a song, will you march and come and give to the Lord tonight?
I'm
all I need. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Lift your hands and give him praise tonight. Hallelujah. Jesus, you're all I need. Do you feel that way tonight? You're all I need tonight. Jesus, you're all that I need tonight. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. The Lord's in the house tonight. Hallelujah. The Lord is here. Jesus, you're all I need. You're my fortress. You're my strong tower. You're my righteousness. You're my peace. You're my joy. You're all I need tonight, Father. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. I want to read one scripture to you while you remain standing. And before I do that, if you haven't already heard, Sister Allen and lost her mother this week, and Brad lost his grandmother. She was, as you know, with us on watch night service, and I believe it was just God that spoke to me to have her testify. Hallelujah. And how refreshing it is for me to hear it out of her own words, thanking God for her salvation. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. And so I received a text from Sister Allen. The funeral was going to be on Tuesday. The viewing's at 10 a.m. and the service is 11 a.m. It's going to be in Ohio at her home church in Youngstown, Ohio. Amen. And so I'm going to represent the church, so pray for me. They've asked me to say a few remarks, and I am hoping to play that tape of her giving God praise for, I don't know, 45 or 50 years of salvation. Hallelujah. I can't say it any better than that. Praise God. But if you would tonight, let's have special prayer for the Allen family. Call Brother Brad before the Lord, Sister Allen, their entire family. Father, we pray tonight for the Allen family. I pray for Brad and Sister Allen and Rick tonight, Lucy tonight, God. Let the peace of God be upon them. Let the Holy Ghost overshadow them. Meet every need that they got. Lord, during this time of sorrow and grief, be the peace in the middle of the storm, I pray. Let your anointing rest upon them. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we call their names before you. I pray for Bradley tonight, God. He karomo husata rabahai. He la rabakayo robo husanda. He karayoto yata rabahai. Let your blessing be upon him. Karomo hutoi. Comfort him tonight, God. Comfort him tonight. In the name of Jesus, we give you thanks and we give you praise tonight, God, because you are the comforter. You are our comfort tonight, God. We thank you for Sister Johnson, and we thank you for her example. We thank you for her love for you tonight, God. I give you praise and I give you thanks in the wonderful name of Jesus. And then everybody say amen. Amen. Praise God. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9, he said, "But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light." Hallelujah. That you should show forth the praises. We've got a right to praise him. That I would show forth the praises. Thank you, Lord, for my salvation. Thank you for where you brought us from. Thank you for all that you have blessed us with, Lord. You've been good to us tonight. We praise your holy name. God bless you. As you're seated, why don't you clap your hands to him one more time. Praise God. Praise God. I can't help but think about that song we were just singing, He's All I Need. Jesus is all I need. He's my portion. He's my strength. He's my hope. He's my all in all, the Bible says. Hallelujah. Another scripture says we can do nothing without him. Hallelujah. I need him tonight. How about you? I want him tonight. How many of you are glad that he called you? That's about five of you. I said, how many are glad God called you? He called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. He took the darkness out of your heart and put some light in its place. Oh, praise God. I'm glad he called me. Hallelujah. I want to tell you, God has called every single person that is in this house. I said, God has called you, and God has brought you into his marvelous light. He has put the Holy Ghost inside of you. Hallelujah. He's given you power when you were powerless. He's given you hope when you were hopeless. He's given you joy and strength. Hallelujah. And he has told us that we can do all things through Christ that strengtheneth us. I said, God called you. God called you. God called you by name. God called you by name out of darkness. Hallelujah. He could have chosen anybody else, but he chose you and he called you. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad for that call tonight? Aren't you glad that Jesus called you? Hallelujah. That he pulled you out of darkness, that he breathed the breath of righteousness in your soul, that you, hallelujah, tonight are not your own, but you're bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He said, therefore glorify him. Therefore praise him. Therefore exalt him. Why? Because he picked me up out of the miry clay. Hallelujah. Praise God. I think you ought to get a little more excited about your salvation tonight. I think you ought to give God a little more praise. Hallelujah. Because I am redeemed by the blood of the Lamb tonight. I'm not a has-been. I'm not a nobody. I'm not a down-and-outer. I'm not a castaway tonight. But he called us. Hallelujah. Sister Maria, he called you. He called you and he's empowered you. And he's breathed his breath into your life. And he's given you power. And he's given you dominion. So when the devil comes in knocking on your heart's door and tries to steal your faith and tries to steal your joy, tries to steal your vision, there ought to be some Holy Ghost that wells up on the inside of your soul and says, no, devil, you're not coming in. You're not going to spoil my house. I belong to the Lord. The blood of Jesus has been applied. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Just as the death angel passed through, amen, on Passover night, amen, and all those that had the blood applied, amen, he just passed right on by. So the blood of Jesus is applied to our lives tonight. So when the death angel or the adversary, the devil, comes knocking on your door, he just has to pass on by because the blood has been applied to your life. Somebody give him praise. Hallelujah. So I want to tell you tonight, God called you. God called you. I didn't call you. Grandma didn't call you. Brother or sister didn't call you. God called you. And God called you by name. He could have spoke anybody else's. I've heard it preached before about Lazarus being in the tomb dead. Amen. And they said, why weren't you here, Jesus? But he says, hallelujah, Lazarus, come forth. And what happened? When he called Lazarus's name, oh, Lazarus came hopping out of the grave. Because when Jesus calls your name, something's going to take place and something is going to happen. Amen. Hallelujah. I said, he speaks life to the lifeless. He speaks hope to the hopeless. He speaks power to the powerless tonight. I've come to tell you, you're not a castaway. You're not a has-been. You're not a nobody. But God has called you and endued you and given you power and given you dominion and given you authority tonight. Hallelujah. That you might show forth forth the praises of him who called you out of darkness, that there might be some joy down on the inside of your soul tonight. Say, praise God. I may be going through a trial, but I'm going to praise my Jesus anyway. Hallelujah. I'm going to praise him for every trial. I'm going to praise him for every temptation. I'm going to praise him for every rock and hill I had to climb. Hallelujah. Because it may be darkness right now, but I'm going to reach the top. Me and Jesus are a majority, and through him I can climb the mountain. Through him I can jump over the hurdles and the walls. Through him I can succeed. Why? Because there's a call upon my life. There's a call upon our lives tonight, church. We are not just another denomination down the street, but we are the called of God. We are a chosen generation. We are a royal priesthood. Amen. God has called you to show forth his praises, to bless him, to praise him, to tell this world how great your God is. Somebody give him praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said, God called you. God called you for a work that, and a purpose that he has for your life. Praise God. Praise God. I said, God called you for a purpose. Hallelujah. Praise God. I want to fulfill God's purpose. How about you? Praise God. Hallelujah. I remember years ago, my father drilled a scripture into my head that God has just quickened to my spirit. I can't even tell you where it is, but it's in there somewhere. Praise God. Praise God. But the scripture was this. It said something like this. A workman that putteth his hand to the plow and turneth around is not worthy of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. He said, God has called you. God has put your hand upon the plow. There is no quitting. There is no giving up. There is no turning around. There is no going to the left or the right or going backward. There's only one way to go, and that's straight ahead towards Jesus tonight. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I put my hand to the plow. I'm not going back. I'm not giving up because my God can do anything. My God does have all power in heaven and earth. Hallelujah. What I need to do is be endued with some fresh anointing. Let some fresh power come down on the inside of my soul. Amen. And when the devil comes in, I'm going to lift up that shield of faith and say, devil, you're not spoiling my house. You're not taking my joy. You're not, amen, coming in and taking what the Lord has provided. Hallelujah. I'm called of God. I'm a chosen generation. I'm a royal priesthood. I'm a holy nation. Hallelujah. I'm gonna do what God called me to do. Anybody feel that way tonight? Romans 11 and 29 said, for the gifts and the calling of God are without repentance. Hallelujah. In other words, if God has called you, don't stand before him one day and say, I'm sorry, God. I didn't do what you told me to do. He said, the gifts and the calling of God are without repentance. Hallelujah. In other words, if I put my hand to the plow, keep on plowing. Keep on striving. Keep on pressing towards the mark for the prize in the high calling of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Why? Because God has called us. Amen. And God has purposed us to be the light in the darkened world. To be a light that will shine. Why? Because God loves people tonight. Amen. I said God loves people tonight. God loves you. God called you because he loved you. Hallelujah. And God loves people tonight. Hallelujah. And it is God's will, hallelujah, to use his people in this last day to be a shining light in a darkened world. Hallelujah. I said it's God's will tonight to use his people to be a shining light in a darkened world. So God has given you the Holy Ghost that you might shine brightly in this darkened world, that others might see God in you and give him glory and give him praise and bless his holy name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Help me to be a light, Jesus, that will shine. Help me to fulfill your purpose, I pray. Hallelujah. Help me, oh God, to show others the way you called me. I pray, call others, God. He has called you into a ministry tonight. Hallelujah. He's called each and every one of us into a ministry tonight. Amen. Well, you say, well, I don't know what kind of ministry that I have. Well, if nothing else, he's called you to be a soul winner, to be a light, to tell somebody how good your God is, to tell your testimony to somebody about how God pulled you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Amen. Some of us, we want to get the Bible down. We want to argue the Bible. You don't have to argue the Bible. Just simply tell your testimony to somebody. They cannot argue with your testimony. When you tell them what God has done for you, you are lifting up the name of Jesus. You are magnifying the name of Jesus. And he said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men nigh unto me. Our job tonight, amen, is not to be a walking encyclopedia or a walking Bible, but our job is to lift up the name of Jesus. Our job is to praise him during the storm. Our job is to praise him when things are going bad, that the rest of the world says, hallelujah, they got a smile on their face. I know they're going through troubles and trials. Everything's not rosy for them, but they got a song in their soul. They got a smile on their face. They got a, hallelujah, some spunk in their step, if you will. Praise God. Hallelujah. Why? Because God has called us. We know who we are tonight. We are the chosen of God. We are a royal priesthood. We are a holy nation. I am not forsaken. I am not forgotten about. I am not cast down. God is on my side. Give him praise. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. God's calling upon your life is not just a career or something that you choose to do. Hello. Amen. Now, some of you come to me and I give you jobs to do, but that may not be your calling. And sometimes it's like me putting a square into a round hole or a round peg into a square hole. Amen. Because only you know what your calling is. Amen. Hallelujah. And God wants you to fulfill your purpose. Amen. So we don't choose what we do for God like we choose a career or a job. Oftentimes I'll hear some of you say, I need a job, Pastor. Well, I want you to have a ministry, not a job. Because if it's a job, you'll quit. If it's a ministry, you'll fulfill the call. Hello. Praise God. Hallelujah. I believe there's a difference. Amen. And I want you to know tonight, hallelujah, and I want to get this point over again. It's not a choosing like a career or a vocation, but it's a call or a tug of the Lord upon your heart. Hallelujah, that I could tell you my own testimony, but it would take too much time. But what I will tell you tonight is when God put the calling into my heart, I couldn't get away from it. I tried to run from it. I tried to hide from it. I tried to get around it. I tried everything I could think of. Amen. Because I was determined not to be a preacher. And the harder I ran, the more God pulled the carpet out from under my feet. Until finally, I surrendered. Can I tell you that's what God's waiting for you to do? God is waiting for each of us to be willing to surrender and say, yay, Lord, not my will. I don't know about you, but when God filled me with the Holy Ghost, I said, Father, I'll go anywhere you want me to go. I'll say anything that you want me to say. I will do anything that you want me to do. And he happened to pick the thing I didn't want to do the most. And here I am tonight. Praise God. Good or bad, happy or sad. I don't know how y'all feel about me, but praise God, here I am anyway. Praise God. I'm trying to fulfill the purpose that God has called me to. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank God for his call tonight. Hallelujah. Thank God for his call tonight. I'm reminded, well, I won't even go into all that, but just give him praise. And why don't you just lift your hands and thank him for his call. Thank you, Lord, for calling us. Thank you for your hand upon us. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So I want to remind us again that the call is a divine call. Hello. God has done the calling. It's a divine call, and it's a divine will and purpose of his. Amen. So the Lord tonight is waiting on you. I wanted that to sink in a minute. I said, God is waiting on you. How many times we say we're waiting on God? Well, God is waiting on you. God is ready. That's right. I said, God is ready. God is ready to heal. God is ready to deliver. God is ready to set free. God is ready to open a door. God is ready to show his handiwork. God is ready to show up and to show out. Hallelujah. But the Bible also tells us that he could not do many mighty works because of their unbelief. So if you don't believe that God's going to show up, if you don't believe that God's going to heal your body, if you don't believe that God's going to open a door, if you don't believe that God's going to provide, then he's not going to do it. But if you get a little tenacity in the Holy Ghost and say, my God has never failed me, my God is an on-time God, I don't know how he's going to do it, I don't know when he's going to do it, but I'm going to give him the praise in advance. I'm going to thank him, and I'm going to call those things that are not as though they are. I'm going to praise you for my financial miracle. I'm going to praise you for that new job. I'm going to praise you for my healing. I'm going to praise you for making my enemies to be at peace with me. I'm going to praise you for the victory tonight, God. Why? Because you're an on-time God. Hallelujah. All I got to do is praise you and thank you, and you'll open up the windows and you'll pour out upon your people a blessing. Why? Because you love us and you're concerned about us, and we're your children tonight. We're not just somebody, amen, that don't know where we're going. We know where we're going. We know how we're going to get there. We're the called of God. We're the chosen ones. We're the royal priesthood. Oh, bless the Lord. That's why we can stand and say, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. I'm going to bless his holy name. Why? Because everything that's good cometh down from my Father above. Every good and perfect gift comes down from him. Amen. Every blessing in the book is mine. Every promise in the book is mine. Hallelujah. Praise God. I don't have anything to be downhearted about. Amen. Take this whole world, but give me more of Jesus. Amen. I believe it's not going to be too much longer. That trumpet's going to sound. We're going home to be with him anyway. Hallelujah. And all the stuff that we've worried about and fretted about, it's going to be behind us. Praise God. Hallelujah. Why? Because God has some blessing in store for his children. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a clap offering of praise. Hallelujah. We all can quote this scripture, Romans 8:28, and we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. Hallelujah. Are you called according to your purpose, or are you called according to his purpose? Hallelujah. Help me to fulfill your purpose, God. Help me to make that dedication in my life. Not my will, but thine be done, Lord, in Jesus' name. Praise God. So what is God's purpose for your life? We think God's purpose is so profound that we complicate it. Amen. That we think we got to learn Hebrew and Greek to figure out exactly what God's purpose is. I don't believe that. I believe God's made it simple enough for a child to understand. So I'm going to give you some of God's purposes for your life tonight. Amen. They may not be the purposes that you have, but these are God's purposes tonight. Praise God. You may want, amen. I'm not even going to go there. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. We'll get off on a tangent. Praise the Lord. But his purpose is to give you power. Amen. Because he said in Acts 1 and 8, you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. So none of us that have the Holy Ghost can stand before God and say, I just didn't have enough power to get the job done, Lord. Because we've got all power living on the inside of us. So God has given you, one of his purposes is to give you power. Another purpose is to give you peace. God does not want you to be tormented. God does not want you to be stressed out. Hello. Romans 8 and 6. To be spiritually minded is life and peace. Hallelujah. Praise God. To be spiritually minded, Romans 8 and 6. Amen. Hallelujah. Somewhere in there. Amen. To be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded, he said, is life and peace. I can have peace tonight. I can lay my head down and sleep like a baby because the peace of God reigns in my soul. So one of God's purposes is to give you power, to give you peace, and to also to give you confidence tonight. Confidence that God is able to do what he said he will do. Hallelujah. Guess what? God is not a liar. Amen. Proverbs 3:26 says, for the Lord shall be thy confidence. Yes. The Lord shall be thy confidence. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord shall be thy, not my confidence, not my will, but if God be for me, who can be against me? Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord has given me confidence that when I pray, something's going to happen. That when I trust him, that he is going to come through. Hallelujah. I can have confidence tonight that God will do what he said he'll do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That God has put that call on the inside of my soul. And as long as I'm striving to fulfill his purpose, I can have confidence that I'm going to achieve it. Why? Because God has put that within me. Another purpose is to give you security. Amen. Praise God. Romans 8, 38 and 39. The Bible tells us nothing shall be able to separate us from the love of God. Hallelujah. I'm persuaded. Neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, or powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. I can have confidence tonight. I can have security tonight that God before me, who can be against me? All I need is more of Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah, has angels encamped around about us tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As Elijah told his servant, he said, look up there on the hillside. There'll be more before us than be against us tonight. Oh, God, open our spiritual eyes to see that God is for us tonight, that every angel he has is on our side. Praise God. Amen. Even though the devil may come in like a flood, he said, I will lift up a standard against the wiles of the devil. Praise God. I have security in my God tonight. Praise God. Another purpose is to help us in our times of weakness. Amen. Our flesh is weak. Amen. But Romans 8:26 says, likewise, the Spirit helpeth our infirmities. Amen. The Spirit helps our infirmities. The Spirit helps us when we are weak. Amen. There's be sometimes that you can just barely get the name Jesus out of your mouth. Hallelujah. But that's all you need is to say his name. Hallelujah. Amen. When the devil comes to attack you, all you need to say is Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise his name. You say that Jesus. Amen. And I've literally felt attacks from the enemy come, but I say Jesus, and all of a sudden they run. Amen. Why? Because they don't like the name of Jesus. Amen. And they don't like people that know who their God is. And they don't like people that know, amen, that greater is he that's in them than he that's in the world tonight. Amen. Praise God. Another purpose is to give you a clear conscience. Amen. Yeah, that's right. We just did this on watch night service. We prayed. We repented of our sin. We've come into this new year, hopefully, with a clear conscience. Amen. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become brand new. That's why I read to you on watch night service, Romans 8:1. There is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. There's no more condemnation. So if you've already repented, it's under the blood. Leave that sin under the blood. Amen. Tell the devil that he's a liar and he's the father of lies, that your sins are under the blood of Jesus. Amen. And there won't be any more guilt. There won't be any more condemnation. Amen. There'll only be peace and liberty in the Holy Ghost, and you'll be able to lift your hand. You'll be able to praise God. You'll be able to worship him. Why? Because you have a clear conscience before God and a clear conscience before man. Another purpose is to receive fulfillment. God wants you, amen, to be fulfilled in your walk with him. Hallelujah. Amen. We used to sing an old song. I'm satisfied. I'm satisfied. I don't even know the rest of the song, but I remember that part. Praise God. Brother Haney, you say, don't sing that song because you should never be satisfied. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. But what I do know is I can be fulfilled in my God. Philippians 4:19, he said, I can do all things through Christ that strengtheneth me. I can be an overcomer. I can live victorious. I can be a Christian. I can walk in the power of his might. Praise God. I can be fulfilled because as long as I've got Jesus, Jesus fulfills everything in my soul. Hallelujah. That's one of his purposes tonight. And another purpose is for you to be free. Hallelujah. Praise God. Freedom. Aren't you glad you live in a country where you can worship God in freedom tonight? Praise God. Hallelujah. Not only free, amen, in your worship or in church, praise God, but you can be free in your soul and you can be free in your mind, because we know the scripture says in John 8:32, he said, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Praise God. Thank God for truth tonight, for it's the truth that's going to make you free. Amen. I just want to give a little plug tonight. Thank God for doctrine. Thank God for the oneness of God. Thank God for the doctrine of repentance and baptism in Jesus' name, the new birth, the infilling of the Holy Ghost. Thank God for holiness. Thank God for righteousness. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank God for doctrine tonight, because when we fall in love with truth, hallelujah, it's the truth that breaks the chains of bondage. It's the truth that makes your soul free. It's the truth that gives you power to lift your hands up and say, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Whom the Son has made free is free indeed. I praise you, God. You are free to worship. You are free to bless him. Hallelujah. You are free. Hallelujah. Thank God for your freedom tonight. Praise God. So I want to say it again. God's purpose in your life is to give you power, to give you peace, to give you confidence, to give you security, amen, to help you in your weaknesses, to give you a clear conscience, to fulfill you, and to give you freedom. Those are the blessings of the Lord. Hallelujah. I know you're not getting too excited about it because you're probably sitting there saying, I'd rather have $1 million. Well, I don't think so. Amen. I'd rather be free of death, hell, and the grave than have $1 million in my bank account tonight. Hallelujah. I'd rather be free and know that my name is written in that Lamb's book of life. Hallelujah. I'd rather know that if God is with me, I can say the name of Jesus and the devils of hell have got to run. That's power tonight. Hallelujah. What am I trying to say? God, you are a child of purpose. You are a child of promise. You are a child that's been called. You are a child that knows where they're going. You are on track with God tonight, and he wants you to fulfill your destiny tonight. He wants to fulfill his purpose in you if you'll just say, yay, Lord, here am I. Use me. Here am I. I present myself to you. Hallelujah. And God will use you in a greater dimension than you ever began to dream possible. Praise God. Praise God. Called according to his purpose. Those are some of his purposes tonight. So now, why do we exist? We're not here just to take up space. Amen. But God created you to worship. I'm going to say that again. You're all looking at me with a blank stare on your face. God created you to worship. You're going to worship something. I hope it's him. Praise God. He created you to worship. He said in Matthew 4:10, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God. Thou shalt. Not would you please. Thou shalt worship. Thou shalt worship. Thou shalt worship. It is a command of God. And your blessing is not going to come until you learn to worship him. I said your blessing is not going to come until you learn to worship him. Because he intends to be worshiped. You know the scripture says if we don't worship him, he's going to cause the rocks and the mountains to cry out. Because something that he created is going to worship him. Hallelujah. He's not saying, do you want to worship me? No, he's saying, when you come into my house, come in with thanksgiving in your heart, with praise upon your lips. Come to worship. Come to worship. Come to praise me. Come to lift me up. Come to create an atmosphere that when the sinner and the backslider and the cold and the lukewarm and the indifferent walk through the door, that there is a power of God. There is an anointing of God flowing in this house. Hallelujah. That the chains are broken. The captives are set free. Why? By the delivering power of God. That's why he wants you to worship. He wants you to create an atmosphere where sons and daughters can be born into the kingdom of God. The world is going to hell without a hope in God. It's dependent upon the church to be the church and to worship him. To worship him and to worship him. Praise God. Created to worship. Created to praise. That's why David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. I was glad to go to the house of God. I was glad to worship. I was glad to worship. Hallelujah. God, you're an awesome God. I'm so glad you saved me. I'm so glad you filled me with the Holy Ghost. I'm so glad you called me out of darkness. I love you. I praise you. I worship you. Hallelujah. Created to worship. Called to evangelize. Yes. Called to evangelize. Yes. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel, not just to the preacher, to every born again believer, to every called of God, to every chosen generation, to the royal priesthood. Go. Go and make disciples of all nations. Go and preach the word. Go and lift him up. Go and testify of him. You're created to worship. You're created to evangelize. You're created to have fellowship. And this is directed. We're going to go into this new year and we're going to establish some new home groups. And some of you I know are going to tell me, I don't want to do that. Well, I want to tell you by the word of God, he said in Matthew 28 and 18, he said, go and make this, or he said, have fellowship one with another from house to house. Amen. Go from house to house and worship, hallelujah. Go from house to house and evangelize. Go from house to house and have fellowship. Because you are not going to be victorious very long if you're an island to yourself. We are the body of Christ. You were created to have fellowship. In Acts 2, they went from house to house, breaking bread, and having fellowship one with another. And God added to the church daily such as should be saved. Hallelujah. From house to house. Praise God. I haven't said a whole lot about it, but the game plan, hallelujah, amen. This is how we're going to evangelize Maryland, D.C. I said it at the GO conference, amen. It's still in my heart. It's still prevalent for this church, amen. We're going to start with home Bible studies. We're going to try to teach as many home Bible studies this year as we possibly can. Because that's evangelism. Then we're going to try to take those home Bible studies, hallelujah, and turn them in to home groups. When I get four or five disciples, amen, that love the word of God so much they want to have church more than just once or twice a week because there's a hunger for God in their soul, hallelujah, we're going to turn into some home groups, amen, hallelujah. So the Bible study is going to turn into some home groups. Amen. Hallelujah. And then pretty soon it's going to turn into a preaching point where we may not preach there every week, but we will preach there, you know, maybe once a month or whatever. That's a preaching point when I get a little nucleus together and start preaching to them on a regular basis. Not necessarily me, but we got some other preachers around here. Praise God. Hallelujah. They start preaching to them. Then we're going to turn them into a daughter work. Hallelujah. Where we have weekly services. And then when they turn into a daughter work, when they get up and running on their feet and God starts adding and multiplying the daughter work, we'll turn them into an autonomous church and we'll cut them loose and say, go, you're on your own. Hallelujah. And we'll build churches. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm looking to build a church in Ellicott City. I'm looking to build a church in Silver Spring. I'm looking to build a church down, hallelujah, in Landover, Lanham area. Hallelujah. Looking for a church in Glen Burnie. Hallelujah. Looking for a church in Fort Meade. Hallelujah. Anywhere God opens the door, I'm looking to build a church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, go. Oh, God, help us to hear the call. Help us to be about the Father's business. Help us to evangelize our world. Help us to have fellowship one with another. Help us to do the work that you have called us to do, God. Hallelujah. And the Bible tells us that if we'll do our part, he'll do his, and he will add to the church. That means that we're going to grow. We're going to grow. 2017 is going to be a year of growth. He said, I will build my church. I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. God wants to build a church. God wants to save souls. God wants us to reap a harvest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Most of all, he wants us to make disciples. He said, make disciples, preach, teach, baptize. Go forth and preach to them. Teach them about me and preach to them some more. Hallelujah. He said, by the foolishness of preaching, he has chosen to save them that are lost. Hallelujah. Praise God. Make disciples. Preach, teach, baptize, preach, teach, and teach or preach some more. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. So what does God want you to do? I'm going to bring it all the way home to us individually tonight. Praise God. What does God want you to do? Well, first of all, he wants you to love him with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. Not just lip service, but heart service. Hallelujah. I'm going to love God with all my heart, with all my mind, with all my soul. God wants me to love my neighbor as myself. Hello. I hate to admit it, but many of us don't even know our neighbors. We need to get to know our neighbors. Hallelujah. We need to go and make disciples. We need to teach them all things, the Bible says. And we need to demonstrate God's love. Have compassion one for another. He said, by this shall all men know that you are my disciples if you have love one for another. Hallelujah. If you will love God, if you will love your neighbor as yourself, if you'll go and try to make disciples and teach and demonstrate God's love, revival is a natural reaction. Praise God. Some of you got real quiet on me. I tell you what, I've made up my mind what my new theme's going to be this year. That focus that was up there earlier, that's coming down. My new theme is be the church. Be the church. Be the church. Go out of the doors of the church and be the church. Show some love to somebody. Show some compassion to somebody. Show some kindness to somebody. Teach somebody a Bible study. Get involved with the world in which we live. Be the church. Don't talk the talk, but walk the walk. Amen. You see your brother in need? Amen. Give him a cup of water or give him whatever. Amen. Give him the coat off of your back the Bible talked about. Amen. Hallelujah. So, amen. And if we will be the church, we will possess the land that God has given us. This is our land. We have the authority tonight. We have the power of God living into us. Hallelujah. All we need to go, he said, I've already opened the door. I've already given you the land. He told them, go in and possess the land. All we got to do is go in and take what's ours. Hallelujah. I said, all you got to do is go in and take what's yours. Hallelujah. God's already given you power. God's already given you dominion. God's already given you authority. Just go take from the devil what the devil has stolen. Tell the devil to give it up. Take it. Hallelujah. The Bible says the violent taketh it by force. Take it. Hallelujah. Take it by force if you have to. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Say, devil, you're a liar. You're the father of lies. I command you to give up. I command you to hold not back. Hallelujah. When I pray God send forth ministering spirits into our world. Hallelujah. Help us to reach the hungry. Help us to reach the thirsty. Help us to reach the lost. Let the waters of baptism be troubled in every service. Let sons and daughters be filled with the Holy Ghost in every service. Hallelujah. Help us to teach Bible studies. Help us to form home groups. Help us to establish new churches. Help us to fulfill your will and help us to fulfill your purpose, because I am called. I am called, oh God. Here am I. Don't send somebody else, God. Send me. I volunteer for service tonight. I volunteer for the army tonight. I volunteer to do whatever it is, God, you want me to do. Clap your hands. Make a joyful noise. Praise God. Praise God. The early church, amen, impacted their world. The 120 in the upper room on the day of Pentecost. Later that same day, the 3,000 that was added to the church. There's another 5,000 that was added just a little bit later. Hallelujah. What am I trying to say? The church was unstoppable. You can't stop the church. You can't stop the church. Amen. You can't stop it. Hallelujah. When the wind gets blowing and the people get on fire and the vision is caught. Hallelujah. You can't stop the church. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Sometimes it all just determines on what you see. Joshua and Caleb, we remember how they went in and spied out the land, and they're the only two disciples that we can really remember their names. Why? Because they brought back a good report. The other 10, we don't even remember. Most of us don't remember their names because we don't want to associate with those that brought back the evil report. Hallelujah. But Joshua and Caleb said, we're well able to take the land. The others said, there's giants in the land. Some people are going to make all kinds of excuses why we can't do anything for the kingdom of God. But there's got to be some Holy Ghost rise up in us that says, hey, we're well able. We're well able to take the land. I'm going to be a Joshua. I'm going to be a Caleb. I'm going to see what God wants me to see. I'm going to go where God wants me to go. I'm going to do what God wants me to do. I'm going to fulfill my call. I'm going to fulfill my purpose. Hallelujah, because I'm called according to God's purpose tonight. Clap your hands and make a joyful noise unto him. Hallelujah. I don't want to be one of the five foolish virgins that let the oil burn out of my lamp when the bridegroom came. Amen. Only the five that protected what they had were ready to meet the bridegroom. Oh, God, let us be full of the power. Let us be full of the anointing. Let us be full of the Holy Ghost. Let not our souls be lukewarm and cold and indifferent, but let us be full of the power of God. Amen. Hallelujah. He told the Philadelphia church in Revelation 3, he said, I know thy works. Behold, I have set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it. And no man can shut it. And no man can shut it. God has set before us an open door. God has opened the door. God has said, go in and possess the land. God said, no man can shut what I have opened. Go and make disciples. Go and preach the gospel. Go and do the work of the kingdom. That's my purpose. That's my calling. Don't be wondering if I'm going to go be a missionary to Africa or China or Australia or wherever in the world. Just go and make some disciples. Right where you're at. Be a light where you're at. Be a shining light wherever you're at. Hallelujah. Fulfill the call. Fulfill the purpose of God. Praise God. And God has given us open doors. And I'm going to quit with this. Hallelujah. Come and play me some background music. Praise God. Then I'll quit. Praise God. I want to tell you, God's got some open doors. I was reading some of the foreign missionary reports. I got a report. 1,200 Trinitarian preachers were taught about the oneness of God, and 83 of them were baptized immediately. Hallelujah! I said, God's opening doors. Yes, he is. Hallelujah. During 3 oneness conferences, in Muslim-dominated areas, 172 were baptized in Jesus' name, and 55 Trinitarians were also baptized. 55 Trinitarian preachers. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. During a revival in India, hundreds of Hindu priests attended some of our services. and many were healed and delivered. 43 Hindu priests were converted and baptized in Jesus' name. And one of them turned the entire temple over to the United Pentecostal Church. To God be the glory. 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 A pastor of a Trinitarian church had about 800 to 1,000 members, was baptized in Jesus' name, and is now baptizing his entire church in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. I'm trying to tell you, God is using his people. Amen. And God's got a place for you. Amen. It's not tomorrow. It's not next month. Today is the day of salvation. Now is the appointed time. Hallelujah. I want to be called according to his purpose. Stand to your feet. Lift your hands in the air. Let's give God some praise tonight. I love you tonight, God. I praise you tonight. I thank you tonight. Hallelujah. If you want to heed the call of God before we close out and go home, will you make your way to this altar tonight and just say, God, here am I. I want to be used of you. I'm called of you. Use me, God. Use me, God. Come on. Come on. Just come on down. Lift your hands. Make a new dedication. Make a new consecration. I want to be used of you, God. I want to be part of the church. I want to fulfill your call. I want to fulfill your purpose.
You can
have your will. Have your way.
You can use me.
That's it. Come on. Here am I, God. Use me.
You can use anything, Lord.
Use me for your glory, Jesus. Use me for your kingdom, God.
If you can Hallelujah. Use anything, Lord, you can use me. Take my hands, Lord, take my feet. Touch my heart, Lord, speak through me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Use me, Lord. Why don't you sing that tonight with all you got? Take my heart, Lord, take my feet. Touch my heart, Lord, speak to me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Take my hands, Lord, take my feet. Touch my heart, Lord, speak through me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Use me, use me, Lord. want to be used by you, Jesus. I want to be used by you, Lord.
Take my hands, Lord, take my feet, touch my heart.